hard to get sometimes, isn't it? That we can actually be the problem. But sometimes we are the problem in why things are shaking around us. We need to look at ourselves if we're the problem. We wonder, well, why are my finances so bad? Because we go blow so much money. Amen. I don't understand why I'm always having this financial problem. Amen. And we can't see. Maybe it's because we're spending money we don't need to. But in those problems, God is with us. Even when we create them, He's there, isn't He? Look at verse 3. Though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah, that means think about it. Verse 4, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. And in that place in those days, you know, there was these big, like the Red Sea and these seas around, they were big bodies of water. And storms would come upon them instantly. You'd be out there and everything's clear and nice, the sky's wonderful. And over there, storms just come up out of nowhere. And the waters are like terrible storms, like the one when Jesus stilled the storm. Amen. Still, He said, peace be still, and the waves stopped. It was a storm that came up suddenly that they didn't, were not aware of. And that's how a lot of storms hit us. We don't expect them. Just out of nowhere, all of a sudden, we wake up one day and then we're in this storm. Things go bad. Everything goes bad. This way goes bad. This way. Everywhere we turn, there's a storm brewing, and you don't know where it came from. You ever been there? Well, there was this river around the city of God's people that was always calm and always quiet. And that's the river that it's talking about here. And it brings it into play. Not only in the natural was that river there, but in the spirit, and in our spirit round around us, there's a place in God that when things are bad around us and the enemy has come in like a flood, amen, and we're fighting tooth and nail, trying to stay safe, trying to hold things together, trying to keep our peace, amen, and trying to serve the Lord the best we know, and the enemy comes against us, there is a stream that is calm. There is a place that we can go and hide away. There is a place where we can go in a city of God, and where the stream of peace is there. Where no matter what is going around, that we can have a calm spirit. We can have peace inside our spirit, not just in our mind. The Bible says that there is a peace that God can give us that will surpass all understanding. That you can't comprehend why you can have so much peace. Well, there's a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. There's a place, brothers and sisters, that you and I can go to when we have weeks like last week, where all around us things are in turmoil, where we don't understand why we may not feel God and why He's not answering our prayer. Or when we're going through these things and we just don't understand it. There's a place that we can go where we can have peace and we don't have to backslide. We don't have to go out and get drunk. We don't have to go and fight the battle ourselves. But we can just sit and know that God is in control of the situation. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. That's one good thing about being a Christian. We don't have to get all uptight and so found battle, amen. But we can sit and have peace knowing that our God is a big God. He's ever present with us. He's always there. And He's